Hello everyone, and welcome back to my show. Today, I'm going to talk about more of the pros and cons of the OptaVia 5-in-1 program. Now, I'm talking to you because there's so many great things to say about it, but if you go out and you research and you go all over the internet looking and looking and looking, there's always a bad side and a good side to everything, or a pro side and a con side to everything. So I'm going to be truthful with you on the program. Even though I'm an independent health coach with OptaVia, I thought you should know some of the pros and cons that I found over my weight loss journey after gastric bypass. So let's talk about first the pros of the OptaVia diet. The main health benefit of following OptaVia plan is rapid weight loss, particularly for people who need to lose a significant amount of weight, like myself, or those like me who are considering gastric bypass surgery. Now, convenience. Buying pre-portioned, what we call fuelings, packaged foods can be easy and convenient. There is little to need to count calories, it's already done for you. Or carbs, it's already done for you. A simple formula for creating your own meals at home is also convenient. Instead of calorie counting, you will count portions of specific foods, which makes meal tracking easier. Reduced overweight and obesity risks. Okay, let's talk about these. I've talked about them often in my earlier broadcasts, but being overweight or obese can increase the risk of some diseases. We all know that, right? Among them are high blood pressure, type 2 diabetes, heart disease, osteoarthritis, gosh, and various types of cancer as well. Losing just 5% of your body weight can help reduce these risks, and they really can. Improved blood sugar and cholesterol levels is another biggie. While some health experts recommend a more gradual weight loss of 1 to 2 pounds per week, there are some times when a faster rate is preferred for whatever the reason. In my case, I can't tell you how excited I got off after the first week. I lost 5 pounds in 1 week, and I had been trying to lose forever. Maybe one is to save a lot of money for gastric bypass. So for example, studies have connected rapid weight loss with more significant improvements in lipid and glycemic profiles. Now, I know those are big words. What that means is that losing weight faster may be better for people with cholesterol and blood sugar issues threatening their health each and every day. However, this study also found that body composition changes were better with slower rates of loss. Okay, let's talk about another issue. That's one of my favorite ones, one that I think is better than any other thing, and that's coaching support. The OptaVia journey to better health and weight loss also offers support through its coaching program, which some users may find helpful. Coaching might help you keep on track, increasing the likelihood of success. I found it, to be perfectly honest, the number one thing that helped me stay accountable on my journey were my best friends and my coaches. And now, let's talk about some of the cons, the negatives, of the OptaVia diet plan. I told you when I started the broadcast, and I'll tell you each and every time, there's always negatives to anything. I can sit here and talk about all the negatives of Nutrisystem and Keto and Jenny Craig and Weight Watchers, but I'm not doing that, not in these 12 episodes. It's just that I did try those particular diet plans. So the negative to this plan now is there are also some potential downsides to OptaVia's plan that could adversely affect your health. I'm telling you this because every plan you read or every plan that you hear about talks about all the pluses. If you're looking at Golo on TV at night, or you're looking at Nutrisystem on TV, or wherever you're looking at them, they all have, this is how good we are. They'll show you pictures of people large, overweight, next to people real slim, and you sit there and you dream. You dream the day you can look slim again and fit and 10 sizes of clothes smaller and start wearing nice looking earrings. If you want to, nowadays, get you a hat. Look good. And when you look good, you feel good about yourself. That's what's so important. I just want to be upfront and tell you about some of these negatives, okay? This is based, again, on my education at Texas A&M, but let's say it this way. I'm not a doctor, and I'm only saying what I remember being taught from A&M. So here it is. Let's talk a little bit about nutrition or nutrient deficiency. This diet may cause nutrient deficiency if the calorie levels are too low for too long. In addition to restricting calories, OptaVia plans limit food and all the different food groups, including fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, all of which provide essential vitamins and minerals for the body. That's one negative. Okay, let's talk about sports. Sports performance. Dropping weight quickly can also reduce sports performance. So I talked to you in the last episode about professional sports. If you get on the diet, don't get on it till during your off season, not during your season. I noticed this also on the pickleball court. But I learned, however, that Powerade, sugar-free, helped cure the issues of spots floating around in front of my eyes. A review of 10 articles noted, and 10 different articles, although many athletes, fighters specifically in this case, want to reduce their body mass, and doing so too fast can impair their performance, while also risking their health. A very low-calorie diet will not likely support an athlete's rigorous training program, or someone who plays pickleball 3 times a week and racquetball another 3 days a week with rest on Mondays. Just won't work. Some health experts suggest that if an athlete wants to lose weight, it's best to do it in the off-season, and I've told you that before, when your training demands are not as high, not as stringent as they are during the season. And last thing I want to talk about is sales pressure. Coaching support can also be a drawback, let's face it. Critics of the program, not me, this is critics of the program, have called this plan a pyramid scheme because of its multi-level structure. I don't think it is. However, they think it is, and I wanted to bring this up as a negative from what people say. Users who complete OptaVia's program are encouraged sometimes to become coaches, sell the company's products, and recruit new sales representatives. Many times, through social media, this can be a turnoff for potential customers. Now, cost. The plans can be expensive. There's no way about around it. Fuelings will cost you $17, $19 each, not including tax and shipping. And of course, usually if you buy enough, shipping's free. Or the groceries you buy for lean and green meals. Then there's hunger. You're losing weight. And this way can be very uncomfortable and may not be sustainable. I don't agree with it either, but then I look at all the pros and cons in anything that I go out and do. And I did that the same well as I did with OptaVia. And the negatives that I'm mentioning to you, I knew these negatives when I went in, so I was prepared. Didn't bother me at all. But I knew, I didn't go in and find this out later. So very low calories typically cause extreme hunger, fatigue, and other undesirable symptoms. And experiencing hunger can make you more likely to eat outside of the diet plan. So, let me ask you, is the Optavia diet a healthy choice for you? The Optavia diet plan. Now, really, it's a health journey, but a health journey and diet plan, if I was going to run a thesaurus on those words, it's the same thing. Deviates from health and nutrition guidelines that the United States Department of Agriculture, the USDA, encourages. For example, Optavia's 5-in-1 plan tops out at about 800 to 1100 calories per day, an extreme reduction from the USDA's recommendation of roughly 2,000 calories per day for adults. An 800 calorie per day diet is considered a very, very low calorie diet. So understand that one. And should be medically supervised. Now, as a coach, I'm not a medical profession, but I do highly recommend that you get a hold of your family physician, talk to them about this plan that you're on, let them know what you're doing, and let them be sure to be there for you if there's any questions that you have from your physician. To me, extreme calorie restriction can cause fatigue. It can cause brain fog and headaches or menstrual changes. As such, the 5-in-1 option should not be used long term. I was on it, I guess, 10, 11 months before I got on the maintenance program, or transition as they call it, into the normal end of the program. And I don't think I stayed on it too long. I didn't see any side effects other than at the very beginning, and I cured that right off the bat with drinking more electrolytes. Now, Optavia has something they call the 3-in-3, the 4-in-2-in-1 plans, typically supplied between 1,100 and 2,500 calories daily, and can be appropriate for longer periods. However, a positive note here is that Optavia suggests a transition period and then a maintenance period after one reaches their goal. Now, Optavia's plans also provide 80 to 100 grams of carbohydrates daily, representing about 40% of the diet's daily calories. Again, let me go back to USDA again. The USDA recommends a diet that is 45% to 65% carbs. Now, this is one of those things you can't always believe what you read on the internet, but sometimes when I look at some of these organizations that are responsible for the nutrition labels on the back of food, and they do a lot of research, there's a lot of doctors involved, sometimes I have to kind of look at what their recommendations are, at least know that they're there. And the USDA emphasizes grains and dairy products. They're not represented at all in Optavia's 5-in-1 plan. The 5-in-1 plan limits your calories, as I said earlier, to 800 to 1100 per day. So it might not meet all of your nutritional needs. It's also not suitable for pregnant or nursing people, those who exercise 45 minutes per day or more, teens, older adults who are sedentary, or people with diabetes or gout. A word from very well. With the extremely low-calorie eating plans, the Optavia diet is likely to help you shed pounds like you've never seen before. However, whether that weight loss will stick once you go off the diet is much less likely, that according to the critics. This is what many of the critics say, and I just don't agree with it. And before starting any meal replacement diet, consider Rather, you can realistically follow it. Be ready. Get your mindset. If you really want to lose weight, you can lose weight on this program. If you decide to opt for Optavia, you will learn about healthy eating. Trust me. All these recipes that I look at each and every day from our group people, they're all lean and green recipes. And they are phenomenal. And they are great. And they are about as healthy as you can possibly eat. Everything. And you learn how to do all these recipes. So when you go off the plan and you've lost your weight, bingo. You just go and cook and always read the labels and do what you've learned over the whole course of your weight loss. And again, consult with healthcare professional before you start a low-calorie plan. That's always, always recommended. The best diet, always the one that is balanced and fits your lifestyle. Remember, following a long-term or short-term diet not be necessary for you, and many diets out there simply don't work, especially long-term. While many critics do not endorse fad diet trends or unsustainable weight loss, I am here today presenting the facts from other critics in this broadcast, not necessarily from me. Now, you should be informed of your decision of what works best. You should know your nutritional needs, your genetic blueprint, you might say, your budget, and what your goals, your realistic goals are. If your goals is weight loss, remember that losing weight isn't necessarily the same as being your healthiest self. Did you understand that one? Losing weight isn't the same as being your healthiest self. And there are many other ways to pursue your health. Okay? Exercise, sleep, and other lifestyle factors also play a major role in your overall health. Today, let me conclude my podcast of this show by saying the best diet is always the one that is balanced and fits your lifestyle. I have gone back to some of my comments on earlier podcasts and pulled a question or two from one of my listeners. Here's one. I am on the Optavia program now. Why am I so tired? Fatigue is not uncommon for anyone who begins a drastic change in eating habits to lose weight. These effects are usually most notable towards the beginning of a new weight loss program, and sometimes the effect lessens. If you continue a very low calorie diet, the fatigue you experience might not lessen until you increase those calorie intakes. Also, let me conclude by saying a healthcare provider you must go to provide you some guidance if you have any bit of concern about your energy level or your weight loss, or anything to do with the weight loss program. Furthermore, my comments throughout this broadcast, they are not those of a licensed professional. And even more so, because of the various variables, losing weight on this plan has found that the average weight loss is 12 pounds over 12 weeks. Although I have had extensive physical and mental education and health education while going to A&M, I am not professional. Well, I guess that brings me to the end of my podcast today. I'd like you to leave a comment in the bottom. Anything that you can think of, any questions that you have. Again, I'm on the program. I believe in the program. But today's broadcast was more to let you know what other people kind of thought about the program as well. So you are fully informed before you make that decision that you want to jump on the Optavia weight loss program. Also, there's a little button at the bottom to click on to say you like it. And there's a subscribe button. I would love for you to subscribe. I've got many more broadcasts coming up, many different series. I've got my Faith and Inspiration series, my Easter series, my Do You Want to Be an Author? Would you like to write your first book? There's many different series under the different channels of my particular broadcast. So be sure to join any of them and listen to any of them as we continue going. And if you subscribe, well, that way you will have what you need. So until later, I appreciate you listening to my or watching my broadcast today, and hope you can tune in again in the near future to my very next one. And at the end of this whole series, I have a very special guest that I'll be bringing on, has done an amazing transformation and still hanging in there, still doing well on the Optavia 5-1. Vanessa, I hope you'll keep tuning in to see my season finale. Until then, see you later, alligator.